The Kronus Hegemony exists as a military superstate. They muster some of the largest and most aggressive kindreds amongst the Leagues of Votann. Hello and welcome to this Leagues of Votann painting video. In this video, we're going to show you how to paint a Hearthkin warrior in the colours of the Kronus Hegemony. And we're painting the model up to battle ready as well. Now, before we begin painting, the first thing we need to do is undercoat the model. And as you can see here, I've used Chaos Black. Now, the first colour I'm going to be using is going to be ABADDON Black. Now, the reason for doing this is ABADDON Black has a slightly different finish to Chaos Black. So if we make any mistakes, it's a lot easier to tidy up that armour. But first of all, let's start with that base coat. So what I'm going to do is get myself a medium base brush, just apply a couple of dollops on there. And I'm going to thin this down a little bit more than I normally would for a base paint, because we're just going to coat over that armour and just give it a slight different finish. Once I've loaded that brush up, all I'm going to do is then coat that over the armour. Now, it doesn't matter if you get it on the clothes and stuff like that. It's not really the end of the world. As long as it looks black and the armour is coated in ABADDON Black. Now that ABADDON Black is dry, what we're now going to do is move on to dry brushing that armour. So what I'm going to do here is use Thunderhawk Blue, and like I said, we're going to dry brush it with a small dry brush. So what I'm going to do is just get a little bit onto my bristles like so. Then I'm going to do circular motions and crisscross motions. The point here is to remove as much of that pigment as possible, but still leaving traces on those bristles. So once I've done enough of that, I'm quite happy with that. And then I'm just going to start gently brushing that across the armour. Now we're concentrating on the armour itself, but it doesn't matter if you get it on things like his sleeves and stuff like that, because there's a lot of black details scattered across the model. So the easiest thing to do is just go across the whole thing. And with that dry brushing done, you can see it's really picked out the edges of that armour. So what we're now going to do is move on to applying the rest of the base coat. Starting first with Avaland Sunset for that yellow undersuit. Then we're going to move on to Iron Hand Steel for all the silver details. Rakar Flesh for the skin. Catachan Flesh for any leather as well as the beard. Then we'll use Khorne Red for any tubes and pipes. And finish off picking out some bronze details using CITADEL Bronze. But first of all, let's start with our Avaland Sunset. So what I'm going to do is get a little bit here. As a base coat, I'm just going to add a bit of water to it. So I've got that up. I'm just going to make sure I get my brush to a nice point, like so, and then we're ready to start base coating. I'll start on the arm first, working around the rest of those areas of the undersuit. Now, because it's Avaland Sunset and you're painting over black, you want to do a couple of coats of this. Now that we've base coated the yellow undersuit, we're going to move on to the silver details. So most of this is going to be on his gun, but we've also got some details on his backpack, as well as scattered across the rest of the model. If you're not sure, just check the box art for details. Now that we've picked out the silver details, we're just going to paint the skin using Rakar Flesh. Doesn't matter if you got on the beard, because we can tidy back up later with Catachan Flesh. With the skin picked out in Rakar Flesh, we're now going to move on to Catachan Flesh, and we're using this for the leather details, such as the gloves, the belts, any pouches, as well as the beard as well. With the leather and the beard picked out, we're now going to move on to those red details. This is going to be cable, so you've just got a couple on his fatigues here. There's also some just coming out of his backpack as well. Just be as neat as you can. If you're making a mistake, just get some Avaland Sunset and tidy back up. With the red tubes picked out, we're now going to finish off the base coats by using CITADEL Bronze. And this is to pick out just some little brass details or bronze details scattered across the model. So there's just a little bit on this canister here and some little bits on his backpack. With the bronze details now picked out with CITADEL Bronze, we're now going to move on to some shades and contrast. Starting first with Norn Oil, we'll use this for the leather, the metals and the red. Then we'll get some Rattling Grime for the gun casing, and then we'll be using Casandora Yellow for that undersuit. First of all, let's start with Norn Oil. So what I'm going to do is just apply a little bit. I'm going to use the palette here, just so I don't overload the brush too much, so I can just tap some off, make sure I get a nice point. And all we're going to do is then start applying that over those metals, the leathers and the red. And just be mindful it doesn't pull too much. If it does happen, just get your brush and soak up any of that excess. Now that the Norn Oil is dry, what we're now going to do is get Rattling Grime and coat this over most of the casing of his weapon. Still leaving some silver bits, just look like fresh working parts. With the gun casing complete, we're now going to move on to that undersuit, and for this we're using Casandora Yellow. With that yellow undersuit now done, we're going to finish the model off by applying a couple more contrasts. First of all, we're going to get some Gorgrunter fur for the elbow pads and the knee pads, and then we're going to be using Gulliman Flesh for the skin. And both of these are going to be thinned down with contrast medium. But first of all, let's start the Gorgrunter fur. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to get three parts contrast medium. So I'm just going to apply three dollops, like so. Give my brush a quick wash and a dry. I'm going to get one paintbrush of Gorgon to fill and just mix those together. So it's just a little bit thinner. It's not too neat. All I'm going to now do is just so I don't overload the brush too much, get a good point, is then apply this to those elbow pads and knee pads. And that'll give it that nice brown effect that you see on the box art. The knee pads and elbow pads now picked out. What we're now going to do is do the face. And for this, we're using Gulliman Flesh. And again, like the Gorgon Tafur, I've thinned this down with 3 parts contrast medium to 1 part Gulliman Flesh. With the face now done, what we're now going to do is finish off our Hurricane Warrior by basing them. Now, first of all, we're going to be using Catachan Flesh for the base. The reason for this is the next colour we're going to be using is Martian Iron Crust. When that cracks, you'll see brown through the cracks as opposed to black. But first of all, let's start with our base coat. So all I'm going to do is get some Catachan Flesh onto my palette, add a little bit of water, lay my brush up, and then all I'm going to do is then just coat that over the base. You don't have to go mad. Just be mindful when you get around the feet not to get any on the feet. Take your time. With that base coat applied to the base, what we're now going to do is get Martian Iron Crust and just apply that onto the base itself. Now I'm just going to use the large side of the texture tool first of all, just get it on there. Then I'm going to move to the smaller one for a little bit more accuracy. Once it's all on, you want to leave it for around about an hour to dry and then paint the rim of the base in a colour that matches your collection. And for this, we'll be using Steel Legion Drab. There we are, with the rim painted in Steel Legion Drab, our base is now done. With the texture now dry and the rim of the base painted, our Hearthkin Warrior of the Kronus Hegemony is now battle ready. Now there's a couple of things to remember when painting this model. Firstly, when using base paint, try and be as neat as you can. Remember, the neater you are, the better the end result. And if you do make any mistakes, you can always tidy back up at a later point if you want to. Also, when using shades and contrasts, try not to overload your brush as it can quickly run out of control. If you do find that happening, dry off your brush and just soak off any excess. Well, I hope you've enjoyed this video. Hope you enjoy painting your own battle-ready Leagues of Votann, and we'll see you again soon. Bye-bye.